Welcome to the Hindu News Analysis by Shankar AIS Academy. The displayed articles have been chosen for today's analysis from Chennai, Bengaluru, Delhi, Hyderabad and Thiruvananthapuram editions. Now let us start our discussion. This news article is in relation with the 30th anniversary of the fall of Berlin Wall. Note that the Berlin Wall fell on 9th November 1989. The syllabus linking of the news article is given here for your reference. Before understanding the Berlin Wall, let us first understand the geographical location of Germany and its borders. Know that Germany is in Europe and its capital is Berlin. Now let us look at the map. From the map, we can say that the borders of Germany are Poland, Czech Republic, Austria, Switzerland, Luxembourg, France, Belgium, Netherlands and Denmark. Now let us discuss in brief about the history of Berlin Wall. As we all know that Germany, Italy and Japan, known as the Axis powers, were defeated in World War II by the Allied forces of US, France, Britain and Soviet Union. After the war, Germany was divided into four zones under the occupation of the Allies. Note that Berlin was located within the Soviet zone, but it was also split among the four powers, that is America, Britain, France, which formed the West Berlin, and the Soviet sector became the Eastern Berlin. But the relationship between the former wartime Allies strained during the post-war period. They struggled to reach an agreement on the shape of the post-war Europe. By 1945, the United States and the Soviet Union had begun to emerge as ideologically opposed superpowers. Relations between them strained further when they engaged in Cold War. It means these countries are trying to influence and spread their ideologies in other countries. It is known as Cold War, as the US and Soviet Union did not engage in any direct war. Know that Germany became a focus of this Cold War politics, and this resulted in more pronounced divisions between East and Western parts of Germany. In 1949, the Germany under the occupation by the four powers became two independent nations, that is the Federal Republic of Germany or West Germany, which is allied to the Western powers, and the German Democratic Republic or East Germany and is allied to the Soviet Union. In 1952, East German government closed the border with West Germany, and note that the Western Germany, which adopted democratic values and capitalism, became more prosperous compared to East Germany. Hence, people from East Berlin tried to cross over to the West Berlin illegally. In order to prevent this cross-border movement, the East German government, with the support of USSR, constructed the Berlin Wall. It completely separated the Western East Berlin. Know that Berlin Wall was not one wall, but two. From the diagram, you can see that these walls were separated by a heavily guarded mined corridor of land known as the Death Strip. Note that due to the civil unrest and political changes in 1989, the East German government had to loosen some of its regulations on cross-border movement. Following the media reports that the borders were to be opened, crowds were gathered at both the sides, and this was followed by a peaceful demonstration, cross-border movement, and finally the demolition of the wall on 9th November 1989. Now, let us look at the significance of the fall of the Berlin Wall. Politically, it marked the end of Cold War. This led to the disintegration of USSR and the domination of the US in world politics. Almost after 1 year of the fall, Germany was again reunited in 1990. Now, with this background, let us look into the news article. It was mentioned that during the ceremony, the German chancellor said that the gains achieved by the fall of Berlin Wall should not be taken for granted. Note that the fall of the wall and the German reunification represented victory of the values such as freedom of expression from oppression, democratic values and common brotherhood. The German Chancellor's words indicate that such values are most relevant even today. These words by German Chancellor should be looked in the context of instability hanging around the European Union, which symbolizes the most successful political, economic, international integration now, which is starting to decline. Britain is one of the most important EU country, is on the verge of exiting European Union, and also now European Union is facing significant challenges, including the possible divisions in the future. For example, the member countries such as Hungary and Poland were accused of challenging the rule of law. So, we can conclude by saying that democratic values such as liberty, freedom, common brotherhood are hard earned for a period of time. Events in history such as the fall of Berlin Wall represents the people's hard work to achieve their rights. So these values should not be taken for granted. And this is the article says, with this we have come to the end of the discussion of this topic, and the displayed practice question will be discussed at the end of the session. Now let us move on to the next news article. This news article is about the discussion of the Ayodhya verdict delivered by the Supreme Court. The syllabus linking of this news article is given here for your reference. The verdict was delivered by a 5-member constitutional bench. Note that as per Article 145 Clause 3 of the Indian Constitution, the minimum number of judges who are to sit for the purpose of deciding any case involving a substantial question of law as to the interpretation of the Constitution or for the purpose of hearing any reference under Article 143 shall be 5. So the verdict was delivered by a 5-member constitutional bench. Now let us focus on the judgment briefly. This judgment is centered around a dispute between two religious communities, that is the Muslims and the Hindus. Both claim ownership over a piece of land in the town of Ayodhya. First, you should know where this Ayodhya is located. From prelims point of view, note that Ayodhya is the headquarters of Faizabad district in the state of Uttar Pradesh, and this Ayodhya is located on the banks of Sarayu, which is also known as Ghagra River. Know that Ghagra River is one of the main left bank tributary of River Ganga. Let us see the history of the dispute. The disputed property is of high importance to both Hindus and the Muslims. The Hindu community claims it as the birthplace of Lord Rama, who is believed to be an incarnation of Lord Vishnu. The Muslim community claims it as the site of historic Babri Masjid, which was built by the first Mughal emperor Babur. The Hindu parties wanted the land to themselves. They argued that Lord Rama was born at a spot where the central dome of the mosque was built. But the Muslims had different view. They argued that the mosque was constructed in 1528 by Mir Baki, who was the commander of Babur's army, and he built the mosque without demolishing any place of worship. In the meanwhile, the Babri Masjid was demolished in 1992, and post the demolition, the central government had acquired the entire 67.73 acres of land, including the 2.77 acres of the disputed Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid premises in 1993 by issuing an ordinance. The ordinance was later replaced by the Ayodhya Acquisition Act of 1993. However, in 1994, the Supreme Court revived the title suits, that is the rights of the property, and told that the central government would not be the owner but the receiver of the land, and the central government would dispose of the land in terms of the final judgments in the suits. So this 2.77 acres was claimed by the both Hindus and Muslims, and they approached the judiciary. You know that in 2010 the Allahabad High Court delivered a judgment, and as per the judgment, the Allahabad High Court has ordered a three-way partition of the disputed area. It said that the land must be partitioned between the deity Ram Lalla and his Jamasthan, and then the Nirmohi Akara, which is the older order of Hindu saints, and then the Muslim parties. But this judgment was appealed in Supreme Court, and the present judgment is with respect to the appeal mailed against the Allahabad High Court judgment. Now let us see the key points from the judgment. Along with each point, we shall see certain key facts or terminologies from exam point of view. The first is that the Supreme Court has asked the central government to formulate a scheme within 3 months and set up a trust to manage the property and to construct the temple. Next is that the Supreme Court had also asked the government to allot a 5-acre plot to Sunni Central Wakf Board to construct a mosque in a prominent and suitable place in Ayodhya. Here you need to know about Central Sunni Wakf Board from exam point of view. Note that the Central Sunni Wakf Board, which is mentioned in this news article, is nothing but the Uttar Pradesh Sunni Central Board of Wakf. Here Wakf means an endowment or finance made by a Muslim to a religious, educational or charitable cause. Know that Wakf Boards exist in different states, either for a particular state or for a group of states depending on the population of the Muslims in that particular state. Also note that Wakf Boards exist for Sunni and Shia section of Muslims in other states also, and these are formed based on the population. The Wakf Boards are administered as per the Wakf Act of 1995. To manage all the Wakf Boards in different states of India, there is a Central Wakf Council, and it is a statutory body under the administrative control of Ministry of Minority Affairs, and it was set up in 1964 as per the provisions of Wakf Act of 1954. Now let us come back to the judgment. In the judgment, the judges of Constitutional Bench declared that the demolition of the Babri Masjid in 1992 was shocking violation of the rule of law and a calculated act of destroying a place of public worship. In this context, the Constitutional Bench referred to the Places of Worship Special Provisions Act of 1991. Know that this act prohibits the conversion of the religious places of worship as it existed at the time of independence. This act to convey the message that all religions are equal. The bench also said that the Constitution does not make a distinction between the faith and belief of one religion and another, and also all forms of belief, worship and prayer are equal. So the bench has conveyed the message that the government should enforce the commitment to secularism under the Constitution. Next, the Supreme Court has also quoted the findings of Archaeological Survey of India in its judgment. Now let us understand brief about the Archaeological Survey of India, which established the fact that there was a temple below the destroyed structure of Babri Masjid based on the archaeological evidences. If you see that there is one news column in Ayodhya verdict, and this news article has mentioned the comments of Union Minister for Culture. He mentioned that the Archaeological Survey of India reports cited in the judgment would be made public soon in the form of book. Know that the Archaeological Survey of India excavated the site at the direction of Allahabad High Court in 2003. Now let us see in brief about Archaeological Survey of India from exam point of view. It functions under the Ministry of Culture. The prime concern of Archaeological Survey of India is the maintenance of ancient monuments and archaeological sites and the remains of national importance. Apart from this, ASI also regulates all archaeological activities in India as per the provisions of the Ancient Monuments and Archaeological Sites and Remains Act of 1958. It also regulates Antiquities and Art Treasure Act of 1972. Now let's come back to the judgment. While delivering the judgment, the Chief Justice of India mentioned the words from the addenda written by one of the judges. Here, addenda is the plural form of the word addendum, which means appendix, which contains additional material added at the end of the book or other publication. In the addenda of the Supreme Court judgment, quotes from certain literature have also been mentioned. One of the literature is Ain-e-Akbari. Note that it is a 16th century literature which deals with the administration of Mughal Emperor Akbar. This Ain-e-Akbari was written by Abul Fazl, who also written Akbarnama. Know that Ain-e-Akbari, which is a literature work of Abul Fazl, mentions the time of birth of Lord Rama in the Treta Yuga in the city of Ayodhya, and this literature has been quoted by the Supreme Court bench. Similarly, the Balakanda of Goswami Tulasidas has been quoted by the Supreme Court. Know that Balakanda is one of the chapters of Goswami Tulasidas' works called Ramcharitamanas. This Balakanda also refers to the birth of Lord Rama as Ayodhya. Note that Tulsidas is a contemporary of Akbar and also William Shakespeare. And other noted works of Tulsidas include Dohavali, Kavitavali, Geetavali, Krishnavali and Vinaya Patrika. Now we shall focus on some of the key takeaways from the judgment. Now look at the front page news article, which tells that Uttar Pradesh Central Sunni Waqf Board will not go for a review of the judgment. But in this news article, it is also mentioned that the All India Muslim Personal Law Board is considering to file a review petition. The All India Muslim Personal Law Board has said that the verdict neither provided equity nor justice. Now let us see about the All India Muslim Personal Law Board. This board was formed as a registered society in 1972 and it works towards protecting the personal laws of Muslims. Therefore, to summarize the analysis, we have seen in brief about what is meant by constitutional bench. Then we saw in brief about Ayodhya from geographical perspective. Then we saw about history of Ayodhya dispute. Then we have analyzed the important points from the judgment delivered by the 5-member constitutional bench of Supreme Court and the relevant topics like Waqf Boards, Archaeological Survey of India, then about Ain-e-Akbari and Balakanda of Tulsidas, and finally about All India Muslim Personal Law Board. Have a look at this practice questions displayed here, and this will be discussed at the end of the session. Now let us move on to the next news article. This news article is about a World Health Organization initiative to expand access to affordable insulin. The syllabus linking of the news article is given here for your reference. As you know that insulin is a protein and is used as a medication to treat high blood glucose levels. This includes type 1 diabetes, diabetes type 2 and gestational diabetes. As per the news article, more than 420 million people around the world live with diabetes, and most of these people live in the low and middle income countries because the insulin is accessible and available to only 1 in 3 of the poorest countries. This is because of high cost of insulin. This is why the present move to make insulin affordable become very important. Now let us go through two facts given in the news article, and to understand the depth of the problem, report released by the International Diabetes Federation. Based on this report, that is 7th edition of Diabetes Atlas, China had the largest number of patients, about 11.43 crore people, and it is followed by India with 7 crore 29 lakhs. Now let us understand briefly about IDF. The International Diabetes Federation is an umbrella organization of over 240 national diabetes associations of 168 countries and territories. It represents the interest of the growing number of people with diabetes and also those at risk. And its mission is to promote diabetes care, prevention and a cure across the globe. Note that IDF is engaged to tackle diabetes from the local level to the global level. And its programs varies from at the community level to the worldwide awareness, including advocacy initiatives. Know that IDF is associated with the Department of Public Information of the United Nations and is also in official relations with World Health Organization. Now come back to the news article. The article also mentions the National Family Health Survey of 2015-16. It says that about 5.8% of women and about 8% men in India are having blood sugar level above 140 milligrams per deciliter. And these people are in the age group of 15 to 49 years. This shows that a significant portion of Indian youth and middle-aged population is diabetic. Hence, the present WHO move will also help these Indians. Now, let us discuss in detail about diabetes, its types and their symptoms. As you know that blood glucose or blood sugar is the main source of energy for our body, and it comes from the food we eat. Note that the insulin in our body helps the glucose from food to get into our cells and to be used for the energy generation. Also note that diabetes or diabetes mellitus is a chronic disease that occurs either when pancreas does not produce enough insulin or when the body cannot effectively use the insulin it produces to manage the level of blood sugar. In simple terms, diabetes is a situation when the blood glucose in a person's body is too high or it does not reach his blood cells. When this rise in blood sugar is uncontrolled, it will result in hyperglycemia or high blood sugar. For a period of time, having too much glucose in your body can cause serious damage to many of the body's systems, especially the nerves and blood vessels. Now, let us discuss the main types of diabetes. They are type 1, type 2, and gestational diabetes. Now, let us understand type 1 diabetes. This type 1 diabetes is due to the body's malfunction to produce insulin in the body. Therefore, the patients who are suffering from type 1 diabetes require to inject insulin. This type 1 diabetes was previously referred to as insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus, or simply called juvenile diabetes. See that the cause of type 1 diabetes is not known and very serious research is going on it. Now let us look at type 2 diabetes. It is due to insulin resistance, that is a condition in which body cells fail to use insulin properly. Know that this type 2 diabetes was previously referred to as non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus, or simply adult onset diabetes. Know that type 2 diabetes comprises the majority of the people around the world and is largely the result of excess body weight and physical inactivity. Until recently, this type of diabetes was seen only in the adults and it is now also seen in the children, which is a worrying factor. The third form of diabetes is gestational diabetes, which occurs when a pregnant woman without a previous diagnosis of diabetes develop a high blood glucose level. Know that women with gestational diabetes are at an increased risk of complications during pregnancy and at delivery. They and their children are also at increased risk of type 2 diabetes in the future. Note that the gestational diabetes is diagnosed through prenatal screening rather than through reported symptoms. Now, we'll see the symptoms of type 1, type 2 diabetes. Note that the symptoms of type 1 diabetes occur suddenly. They are polyuria, that is urinating frequently, polydipsia, feeling very thirsty, polyphagia, meaning feeling hungry frequently, then weakness, weight loss, and loss of muscle bulk. Know that the people suffering from type 1 diabetes, their wounds heal slowly. Now look at the symptoms of type 2 diabetes. The symptoms of type 2 diabetes may be similar to those of type 1 diabetes, but the symptoms of type 2 diabetes are often less noticeable. But this type 2 diabetes can be diagnosed through medical diagnosis procedure only. But this type 2 diabetes can be known through medical diagnosis. As a result, the disease may be diagnosed several years after the onset of type 2 diabetes, which may complicate the treatment. So therefore, with respect to this news article, we have discussed the important points like the International Diabetes Federation and the report released by IDF, and also the National Family Health Survey and the highlights of these surveys. Then we have discussed the type 1, type 2 diabetes, including the gestational diabetes, followed by the symptoms of type 1, type 2 diabetes. And these are some of the important aspects for your exam preparation. And the displayed practice question will be discussed at the end of the session. Now let us start our session on practice prelims questions. Now consider this question. They are asking that with reference to diabetes, which of the following statements is correct? They have given the four options like option A, type 1 diabetes is due to insulin resistance, and option B, type 2 diabetes is due to human body's malfunction to produce insulin in the body, and option C, majority of the diabetic people in the world are suffering from the type 2 diabetes. Then option D, as gestational diabetes occurs in children due to malnutrition. You know that diabetes or diabetes mellitus is a chronic disease that occurs either when the pancreas doesn't produce enough insulin or when the body cannot effectively use the insulin to manage the level of blood sugar. And there are three types, type 1, type 2, and gestational diabetes in case of diabetes mellitus. You know that type 1 diabetes is due to malfunction of the human body to produce enough insulin to manage the level of blood sugar. Thus, option A is incorrect. And type 2 diabetes is due to resistance of insulin or failure of the cells to use the insulin effectively. Thus, both the statements of A and B are incorrect. Now, see the definition of gestational diabetes, which occurs when pregnant women without a previous diagnosis of diabetes develop a high blood glucose level. This condition is generally referred as gestational diabetes. Thus, option D is also incorrect. Note that in the world, majority of the diabetic people are suffering from type 2 diabetes. Therefore, statement C is correct. Thus, for this question, with reference to diabetes, option C, that is majority of the diabetic people in the world are suffering from type 2 diabetes. Now, look at this question. They are asking that which of the following countries are sharing border with Germany. They have given countries like France, Austria, Denmark, Italy, Switzerland and Hungary. Now, look here. Germany is sharing border with the countries like Poland, Czech Republic, Austria, Switzerland, France, Luxembourg, Belgium, Netherlands and Denmark. Now, you look at the options again. The countries like Italy and Hungary are not sharing border with Germany. Thus, option D, 1, 2, 3, 5 only is the correct option for this question. Now, look at this question. The question is like this. Ayodhya is located on the banks of which of the following river? Option A, Gandak. Option B, Gomati. Option C, Ghaghara. Option D, Ganga. You know that Ayodhya is located on the banks of Ghaghara, which is also known as Saryu River. And note that Ghaghara is the one of the main left bank tributary of Ganga. Thus, for this question, option C is correct option. Now, look at this question, which is about Ainye Akbari. They have given two statements and you have to choose the correct option. Statement 1 says that it was a literary work by Abul Fazl about the administration of the Mughal Emperor Babur. Note that Ainye Akbari, which was written by Abul Fazl, deals with the administration of the Mughal Emperor Akbar but not Babur. Therefore, statement 1 is incorrect. And Abul Fazl was a contemporary of Akbar. Thus, given second statement correct. Therefore, for this question, option B, 2 only is the correct option. Now, look at this question. This question is with reference to Tulsidas. And they have given the two statements and you have to choose the correct option. Statement 1 says that he was the contemporary of Sri Krishna Devaraya. And second statement is about one of his notable works is Ramcharitamanas. Know that Tulsidas or Goswami Tulsidas time period is from 1511 to 1623 and he was a contemporary of Akbar, Sri Krishna Devaraya, even he was a contemporary of William Shakespeare. And his notable works are Ramcharitamanas, Dohavali, Kavitavali, Geetavali, Krishnavali and Vinayapatrika. Thus, given statements are correct with reference to Tulsidas. For this question, option C, both 1 and 2 are correct. With this, we have come to the end of today's Hindu news analysis. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe Shankara AIS Academy YouTube channel. Thank you.